Hi guys, this is Liz Caneda from Sleek Lens. Today we're going to look at the HDR Enhancements Collection or High Dynamic Range Enhancements Collection. This collection comes with 85 HDR Photoshop actions, which can be used to enhance the HDR properties of your photograph and really bring out light, tone, color, and texture. So I have this photograph open. I really like this photograph. I don't know exactly where it was taken, but it could possibly be like Denmark or the Netherlands. But the great thing about this photograph is that there is so much detail and color in the buildings. And what we're going to do is by using these Photoshop actions today, I'm going to show you how you can really enhance that and bring that out and really make that pop in your photograph. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my all-in-one actions and I'm going to use the Vibrant HDR. So once I have the action highlighted, I'm going to hit play. So this action, as you can see, has really added a lot of detail and color back into the photograph. Right, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my exposure. So I'm going to go to my exposure actions and I'm going to choose the darken shadows. And I'm going to apply that. And for this layer, I'm just going to set it at around 70%. I'm going to go back into my exposure actions and I'm going to go for the exposure darken and hit play. Right, and so what that message was telling me was that to actually add this action to the photograph, you need to increase the opacity because right now it's set at 0. So I'm going to set it at 15%. Just so the photograph isn't too bright. I don't want to blow out any of the highlights. The next thing we're going to do is use our base actions. And I'm going to go for the base contrast and clarity. Right, so this action has added a lot of clarity and a lot of detail and sharpening to the photograph, but it's almost too much. It almost looks a little bit unrealistic. So we're going to go ahead and set the opacity down at about 30%. So we've added a little bit of a sharpening effect and made it a little bit clearer, but haven't really made it unrealistic yet. So now I'm going to go back to my exposure actions. And I'm going to choose the brighten highlights. I'm going to hit play. And then I'm just going to turn the opacity down to 50% for this. The last thing I'm going to do is I want to enhance the sky up here. So I'm going to go to my enhance actions. And I'm going to choose the sky enhancer. All right, so what that message was telling me is that nothing has been done here until I use the layer mask and my brush to kind of enhance the areas that I want. So what I'm going to do for this layer is I don't want to make it too much, so I'm going to put it at 50%, and then I'm going to go and use this brush to kind of paint up in the sky. And I'm just going to turn the opacity down just a little bit more. So that's all I'm going to do for this photograph. I'm going to pull up the before. So as you can see, we've changed a lot. We've brought a lot of color and detail back into the photograph. And it's just apparent that the second photograph, the after, is way more beautiful, more polished, and more professional. So we're going to move on to another photograph. So for the second photograph, I'm going to start with my all-in-one actions, and I'm going to go for the all-in-one golden hour HDR and hit play. Right, which has kind of added a nice gold tone to here, but I don't want to make it too orange, so I'm going to set that down at around 50%. Now I'm going to go to my base actions and I'm going to choose the morning light, which has added a lot of light, too much light. So we're going to turn the opacity down here as well to about 50%. Actually, I'm going to make it a little bit lower at 40%. Now I'm going to go back to my base actions, and this time I'm going to choose the contrast and clarity one. So that has added a lot of definition and a lot of contrast and clarity. Too much though, because it almost looks unrealistic. So the key to a lot of these is to turn the opacity down, and you'll really get the actual effect you're looking for. So I'm turning this down to 30%. So, as you can see, there's just a slight change in contrast and definition. Now I'm going to go to my tone actions and I'm going to choose the tone color pop. Hit play. I'm going to turn the opacity down to 50%. But even so, there is a little too much orange in here. I know it is a sunset, but it almost kind of looks strange. So we're going to open this up. I'm going to open the hue and saturation, and I'm going to go to my reds. And I'm going to turn the saturation down a little bit. And I'm going to go to my yellows and do the same thing. And then what I'm going to do is just slightly turn my hue up a little bit so it's not so red. And the last thing I'm going to do is go to my blues and just kind of put the saturation up a little bit just to enhance them. Now I'm going to go to my temperature actions. And I'm going to go for the temperature cooler. Right, so for this action, it's one of the actions where you need to turn the opacity up for it to actually work. And sometimes you're turning your opacity up and down as a guessing game. You just want to try different numbers until you find something that you think is fitting. So I'm setting it at 20% right now, which is just kind of balanced out the warm color and just kind of really brought out the cooler tones here in the sidewalk and up in the sky. So last thing I'm going to do to this photograph is I'm going to go ahead and enhance the sky because there's really these really great clouds in the sky and it's really making a nice color and contrast. So to kind of bring that out, I'm going to go to my enhance actions. And I'm going to go for the sky enhancer and hit play. Right, and what that little warning sign was telling me was that I just need to use my brush on my layer mask here. If I don't, it won't actually apply anything to the photograph. So I have my brush out. I set the opacity at about 30. There is already a lot of definition here. I don't want to make it too sharp. So I've got the layer mask selected. Just go in here and run my brush around the sky here. Right, so that's all I'm going to do for this image. So I can go ahead and pull the before image up. So we've made a really big difference to this photograph. We've brought out the color, the light, the definition, and overall, it's a much more realistic representation of what you would see with your natural eye, as opposed to just this kind of bland, washed out photograph here. So we're going to start on a third photograph now. So I have a third photograph open here, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start with my all-in-one actions, and I'm going to go for the all-in-one golden hour high dynamic range. So the golden hour HDR, and I'm going to hit play. And I'm going to change the opacity of this just down to about 70. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my base actions and I'm going to choose the base contrast and clarity. All right, so this is at a just a little bit too much clarity, so I'm going to knock it down to about 50%. You can see the difference it makes. Now we're going to use a tone action. So I'm going to go to the tone sunset colors because we do have a nice sunset here in the background. And I'm going to hit play. And I'm going to turn the opacity of this down to about 30% just so it's not really, really orange. And I'm going to open up the hue and saturation of this. We'll open the reds. Just turn it down just a little bit. And the same with the yellows, I'm going to turn that down as well. Now I'm going to go back to my tone actions and I'm going to go for the tone yellow and hit play. And I'm going to set the opacity on this one at 20%. Actually, I might want to go a little bit higher, about 40%. And then the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my specialty sunset flare. So down to my specialty actions, I'm going to go for the sunset flare and hit play. And then I'm going to kind of use that all around here. But I don't want it to be too bright. So I'm going to turn the opacity down about 50%. All right, so that's all I'm going to do for this photograph. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up the before picture. So you can see there is a huge difference between the two photographs. We've got a lot of color and light and detail back in this photograph, and we've gotten that out of this kind of photograph, which just kind of has a gray, washed out look. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial today, and hopefully you'll be able to try it for yourself soon.